We've had to spend time repairing the damage to the car. With conditions as they are, I'd suggest you take a set of full wets.
Ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who'll be fronting the grid. Leclerc, Verstappen, and Carlos Sainz. With qualifying complete, all that remains now is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then. Is no stranger to world-class sport, and as of 2022, the USA's Sunshine State is now on the F1 calendar. Welcome back to the Magic City for the Miami Grand Prix. With great opportunities for wheel-to-wheel battles featuring 19 corners, 3.36 miles long, and expected average speeds of 138 miles an hour, the Miami International Autodrome will be sure to create lots of chances to overtake. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Sainz, Hamilton, Russell, Perez, Norris, Oscar Piastri, Gasly, Albon, Mayhem, Magnussen, Ocon, Hülkenberg, Tsunoda, Maldonado, Stroll, Ricciardo, Bottas, Fernando Alonso, Joe, and Logan Sargeant. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. I'm joined again today by none other than Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, obviously there's a lot of development work that goes on with these cars between the Grand Prix. You've been both a test driver and a race driver. What differences are there in the way that you approach those roles?
Yeah, it's an interesting question. They're two very different mindsets. In the old days, of course, they used to cover up to 15,000 kilometres of testing in a season, and that role would be more about working for the team, trying to help them improve the car and drivers systematically as possible, so that the data could be analysed in the most consistent way. When lining up on the grid for a race, however, a race driver's frame of mind is all about what they can get out of the situation on that day, and the car is the tool to help them achieve those goals.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Map is good, but we need to learn the gears, so go into each one when you can. We're going to need some work on the brakes, so put some energy into them and warm the tyres as well, please. No threat of rain for the time being, conditions look good. Okay, so not an ideal parking spot, but let's try and get a good launch upon the race start. okay. Now stay alert for threats around you. Okay, good work. Great pass. Okay, DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Okay, the car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap starting to form. Strategy available on the MFD. work, mate. That brings you up a place. We'll be right back. Okay, be careful. We think you're going to start losing some tyre grip any time now. After these tyres now, we want to finish the race on this compound. Okay, that's Pastor in the pits. Pastor's in the pits. Pastor's coming in for his stop now. Okay mate, we might need to look at a new race strategy after that. I've got some options for you, so go and check your MFD. Good job, nice overtake. Okay, safety car deployed. Safety car's been deployed. Watch your delta. Make sure you keep it positive as we catch the pack. Right, drop your speed. Our delta's too low and we're going to risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Thank you. go, back into the race. Perfect job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop time. We're happy with that one. Okay, some information on Norris. Okay, it looks like the problem's terminal. They're retiring the car. Up to the field a bit, we're dropping too far back. Remember, we need to stay within 10 car lengths of the next car. Let's pick up the pace a touch, please. We need to close to within 10 car lengths of the car ahead. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature, and remember, there's no overtaking until the timing line. Stay in position until the green flags. Manage your tyres. job. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. DRS is now online. Okay, we've got 4 laps of fuel remaining. We've only got 2 laps of fuel left. Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
And that's the checkered flag. What an amazing victory in what has been a great Miami Grand Prix. The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everybody at the team. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Max Verstappen should be pleased with his performance, making gains at the top of the table. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Max Verstappen seemed to just effortlessly weave through the other drivers today without a care in the world. He was definitely my driver of choice.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. No change in the top spot then, but with today's points, their hold on that lead is getting weaker. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport action. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.